Petey Forrest, and I want to do a review of this long neck Kamaka ukulele. And I was in Hawaii with a group in March 2015 on a ukulele tour doing different things. And we went to the Kamaka factory, and I hadn't brought a ukulele with me. I thought I would buy a Hawaiian one. I wasn't sure was it going to be a Koaloa, Kamaka, or one of the other ones, Kanalea. So I knew I wanted one of the K4K ukes, what you call them. So we got a tour at the Kamaka factory, and we met Fred Kamaka, who gave us the tour. He was cool. You can see a picture of him. And we saw where the wood was, and we saw the whole place. I don't want to reiterate it on it, recall it, because I already did two vlogs about my Hawaiian. But anyways, later I got this ukulele at the Hawaiian, the ukulele site. And when I brought it back to Ottawa, I mentioned on the Ukulele Underground forum, I have this ukulele, and someone said, oh, you have a long neck one. Those are popular in Japan. Everyone's popular in Japan. Like, I don't know, but it was kind of funny. You're right, it is long neck. There's more real estate on it. So it was really interesting. And the one thing about Hawaii, it was funny. I was one day walking down the street, and there was these two surfer dudes. And the one guy said to the other guy, hey man, do you really want to do that tomorrow? He said, that means we'll have to get up early. And the other guy looked at him and said, yeah, around noon. It's like they both laughed. They said, yeah, laid back culture. So the ukulele is great for Hawaii. They're everywhere, everywhere you see them. And this is made of the Hawaiian koa. And Hawaiian koa, I find when you bring it back to North America, especially you live in the northern states and in Canada, you got to really worry about humidity because it's very susceptible compared to the martens that I have there made of koa. I guess the koa has been stored here a long time. So, and also this is a fretwood 18 fret, rosewood fretboard and bridge as well, typical. And they use these types of nice friction tuners. And you'll see the 2K for the two generations. And they use black D'Addario Pro Arte strings. And you can buy those, not necessarily from Kamaka, but you can buy them. And the one thing they don't tell you is that every Kamaka has a built-in, you can hear the sound of the sea. It's from Hawaii. You can hear the sound of the sea in it, of course. And a lot of people don't know that. That's why I'm going to say it for the first time. So you're guaranteed to hear the sound of the sea. Now watch this. I'm going to hear the sound of the sea. You see, I just played the C note. You can hear the sound of the sea in every Kamaka. Gotcha. Yeah. Okay, so there's also in the ukes a serial date and a date, manufacturing date, serial number and manufacturing date, sorry. And, okay, so these ukes I find are very jangly. That's why I like it. The Kamakas are like my Martin. Sustain. Tremolo, it's just amazing. And the second and third strings have great third sounding. It's just wonderful. And so you'll like this bright type of jangly ukulele. Now, you can play a bit of blues on it. Oh, the Diamond Head Blues. Oh, the Diamond Head Blues. Oh, oh, oh. So, you can can see this uke is great sounding, the Kamaka sound. And George Harrison, I believe, used to collect these and just give them out like candy to people. Like that biography with Tom Petty mentions, oh, he just pulled one out of the guitar. Here, have one out of his trunk of his car. Here, have a second one. So it's kind of funny. And the one thing about these ukuleles, I should say, is there's a style that John King, amazing player, who his mother had a Kamaka pineapple, learned to do that campanella style. It's sort of Italian Renaissance style guitar playing. I can't really do it very well, but I'll just show you. It's you try to get a bell ringing of the strings. So you try to get that, you get this bell sound. John King's arrangements are famous for that. So it's great for finger picking, strumming, anything you want to do, mixing. So they give you a nice case. It's a nice shaped case, matches. And it does have like this marine blue inside. You know your uke's in good shape in that. And you can order from Kamaka, and I believe it's their 100th anniversary this year, and they're making other things too. I think they make a pineapple one, I'm not sure. But I wrote a song for this, on this, to show you a bit. You can use a bit of the George Formby technique in a bit of instrumental playing. It's called Pineapple X-cesso, because I thought, pineapple for breakfast, pineapple for lunch, pineapple for dinner, pineapple X-cesso. So I'll play a bit of this song I wrote. Smallest harmonica. Take care. Bye.